I encourage you to unlock the secrets in the soil and learn more about the elegant universe below. I'm Dr. Laura Danley. Long live the soil. Long live planet Earth.
I got something I want to ask you.
You got it, buddy.
How'd you get that car in here?
Well, let me tell you. I just made up my mind to find out what's wrong with it, so I started taking it apart and bringing the parts in here to work on. Before I knew it, there she was.
The only reason I did it, Andy, was because you said not to leave the courthouse.
It was a beautiful piece of work, Andy. Oh, I never saw a man work so fast and so expertly. Really a beautiful thing to watch.
Believe it.
Oh, yeah. It was beautiful. Wasn't it beautiful?
It still don't run right. I don't care what you say, it still don't run right.
Well, it runs as good as it can.
Yeah?
That's what you done to it.
You gonna start telling me how to drive again?
All I know is you drive with a
Hold it.
Out
and
I...
Goober, I want to ask you something else. How you figure on getting it out of here?
Out. Well, I reckon I never thought of that. I guess I can't drive it out the door.
No, you can't.
Well, I guess I'll just have to take it apart again and put it together out on the street.
Well, I sure want to see that. You want to see that too, Eddie, because it's a beautiful thing to watch.
Goober, if I was you, I'd start taking that car apart and getting it out of here right now.
Right now?
You got it. Right now.
Well, can I just run the motor one more time and show Gilly the
noise? No. Get it out of here, right now.
Oh, come on, Andy. The poor boy has worked so hard. It's really a...
No! Sheriff's office? Oh, yes, Ms. Corey. Yes, ma'am, I just got back. Yes, it was a nice trip. Goober, don't run that thing in here. I'm on the phone. What, Ms. Corey? Yes, it does sound like the car is right in the courthouse, doesn't it? Shut it off, Goober! Listen, Miss Corey, I'll get over there just as quick as I can. Well, I know. Yes, ma'am. I'll get over there just as quick as I can. Right. Excuse me. Goober!
What, Andy?
Shut it off!
I couldn't hear you with the motor running.
Get out of there and start taking that car apart right now.
Sure, Andy, sure. Well, Gilly, what do you think? Is it fixed or not?
I'm going to sell it.
Sell it? What do you want to sell it for? I got it running like a top.
No, I've had it with this car. You want to sell it for me, Goober?
Well, I don't know. I might be.
Goober!
Andy, I'm taking it apart now. Like this thing.
Goober, I got to go over to Miss Corey's, and when I get back, you better have a good start getting this car out of here. You understand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm going right now. Right now.
Hey, Andy, I'm taking the part. Here I am. I'm right down the chain.
What are you stopping here for?
Boy, what are you doing up on that line?
Well, I just might find it. Who thinks I might get it pretty cheap?
What do you think?
Floyd, this isn't a used car lot. It's the courthouse.
I know that. I realize that, Andy. But as long as the car is used,
yeah, I can take it up to the front yard. You can watch me, Floyd.
Oh, I'd like that. You'd like it too, Andy. Oh, it's a beautiful thing to watch. Just beautiful.
Now, Goober, I'm going to get out of here. Because if I don't, I'm liable to start hollering. And when I get unhollering, I'm liable to take one of these guns out of this rack here and shoot you. You understand?
Yo.
Now, I'm going home. When I come back here in the morning, I want all traces of that car to be gone. You understand that?
Yes, sir. I understand that. By tomorrow morning, you won't ever know there's a car in here. I promise.
You better keep that promise.
Are you sick?
Yeah, I'm sick.
Oh, go upstairs and get a warm bath, and I'll get you some hot
milk. No, I'm not that kind of sick. I'm just sick. Flu burn and everything.
Oh. Well, that reminds me. Eleanor Schroeder called me and told me the strangest story.
Well, it's true.
There is a...
Yeah, there's a car in the courthouse.
Oh, for goodness sakes, how did that happen?
I don't want to talk about it, ain't me. I don't want to talk about it.
Oh. Oh, did Sheriff Jackson get a hold of you?
Sheriff Jackson, president of the Sheriff's Association?
Mm-hmm. He called here and I told him you're down at the courthouse. Did he reach you?
No. I haven't spent any more time in the courthouse than I could help. What do you want?
Well, he and his assistant were coming home from the conference, and they thought they'd like to stop by and see you for a few minutes.
When are they coming?
As soon as they get to town.
Where'd they call from?
Well, I don't know. Somewhere along the road.
Oh, boy, if they come and that car is still in there, I'll say you ain't me.
I thought you said you wouldn't come back till tomorrow morning.
What's that got to do with anything? What's the car doing back together?
Well, Floyd couldn't make up his mind with the body off, so I just stuck it together for a few minutes so he could try it out. He'll be right back.
All right, the door's first. How do you get it off here?
Sandy, what you doing?
I'm trying to save myself from being the laughing stock of the whole state, and you better help me.
Well, don't you think you'll need a wrench?
Goober, I'm gonna get you for this.
Hello there, Sheriff Taylor.
Sheriff Jackson. How you doing, Joe?
Well, we just thought we'd stop in to say hello as long as we were passing through.
Well, I'm tickled to death you did.
You got a car in the courthouse.
Yeah, it's right in here.
How'd you get it in here?
Oh, Goober there put it in here.
Oh.
That's right. I did it. Took it apart piece by piece and got it right in here. Belongs to Gilly Walker. You wouldn't believe how he abuses that car. Speed, speed, speed. That's all he ever thinks about. I've told him, but he just won't listen.
Oh, it's an exhibit, huh? That's very clever, Sheriff. Oh, well, you're putting that traffic safety program right into effect, huh, Sheriff?
Well, yeah.
Well, it's a great object lesson. Many people been in to see it?
Have they? They've been coming in here all day and all night.
By golly, Joe, maybe we ought to have something like this over in Siler City.
I think it's a great idea. A thing like this hits home.
Oh. Goober, what's chances of fixing up something like this for our courthouse?
I can do it, but first I gotta get this one out of here.
Goober, maybe we better leave it up a couple more days. You know, make sure we get the message across. There's nothing like a visual exhibit to make the point, you know what I mean?
Say it again.
Sheriff, Joe, come on, let me show you around town here in Mayberry and show you some of our safety programs.
At Recovery Centers of America, our local team of experts is treating addiction and healing families across the Midwest. With cutting-edge science and medicine behind us, we take a holistic approach to treatment, addressing the source, symptoms, and contributors of substance use and co-occurring mental health disorders.
You don't need to travel far to access world-class care. Our centers are in Indianapolis and the Chicagoland area, so you can achieve recovery close to home. Call now.
Unreasonable. It's how you have to be if you want to change things. Relentless, tenacious, stubborn. The world's children need people like that. People who see impossible as an incentive to try harder. Who will find one good reason to keep going in the face of 1,000 reasons to stop. So shout out to the hardcore who get the hard yards. Because big problems need big solutions. From big game players. You know the type, the dogged, the determined, the
dead. Like some horror movie, right?
Mic check, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Mic check. Mic check.
For the most accurate and reliable local weather, depend on Storm Team 10. Storm Team 10 helps keep you and your family safe, providing the important information you need to know. For the most accurate and reliable local weather, every newscast, every day, depend on Storm Team 10. Coverage you can
be remembered.
A wonderful, loving, caring man. A great grandfather. He was a great husband to my mother.
Ray and his first wife, Maggie, both died on May 26th, exactly 12 years apart. Bob Stevens thinks that's more than just a coincidence.
A message from God. I think it was a sign from God that they're back together.
Of having his parents killed. The motive? Money for a house and cosmetic surgery.
I got a text, "You're getting a boob job for Christmas, LOL."
So why doesn't his sister believe it?
I think there's a lot more to this story.
48 Hours, Saturday at 10, 9 central on CBS.
Coverage you can count on. This is the Wabash Valley's most watched newscast with Kit Hanley, Storm Team 10 meteorologist Everett Lau, and Marty Ledbetter Sports. This is News 10 Night Watch.
Good evening. Thank you for joining us. I'm Kit Hanley. Across the country today, tens of thousands of people in more than 400 cities marched and demonstrated. The hope in all of this is to pressure Congress to pass new gun control legislation. In tonight's top story, CBS News correspondent Natalie Brand takes us to the March for Our Lives rally in Washington, D.C.
Gun violence has got to go.
From Fort Worth, Texas to New York City, Minneapolis to Parkland, Florida, Americans took to the streets to demand stronger gun laws.
Now! Now!
One of the biggest rallies, Washington, D.C., drawing an estimated 40,000.
All Americans have a right to safety.
The first March for Our Lives took place in 2018 after the massacre at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. Jay Doyle's son survived the shooting.
He was there that day. He ended up being locked in a closet for 90 minutes.
The entire Doyle family traveled to D.C. for the original march. Jay returned this year.
Still trying to get some incredibly common sense rules and regulations put in place. That to me is the most disappointing thing.
The Parkland massacre pushed the Republican-controlled state legislature in Florida to enact sweeping reforms, including raising the age to purchase firearms to 21, waiting periods, and red flag laws that allow courts to bar an individual deemed to be a danger from possessing a firearm. Parkland's former mayor, Christine Hunchovsky, is now a Florida state representative.
If you look at where the American people are on this, there is such strong support for universal background checks, such strong support for red flag laws.
Zoe Turay survived the mass shooting at Michigan's Oxford High School last November.
It's definitely still traumatic.
The shooting compelled her to become involved in the youth-led March for Our Lives organization.
What is your message to lawmakers?
That we will not stop. We won't stop until we rectify this issue.
This week, the Democratic House passed a series of gun control measures. They are not expected to pass the evenly divided Senate, but negotiations continue on a more narrow set of reforms. Advocates here say action is long past due. Natalie Brand, CBS News, Washington.
With the recent wave of mass shootings across the nation, many gun violence advocacy groups are seeing an uptick in volunteers. Moms Demand Action is one of those groups. It's a group that formed after the Sandy Hook shooting almost 10 years ago. There's a chapter in all 50 states and more than 8 million volunteers nationwide. In Indiana, one group leader says thousands of new people have joined the cause in the past month. There are now more than 25,000 Hoosiers taking up a role of activism.
They are going to become volunteers, and they are going to use their time, their efforts, and their energy to contact their legislators and to fight for gun sense in America.
Now, she says you do not have to be a mom to join. Anyone can volunteer. If you are interested in joining the group, text ACT to 64433.